our first tag is HTML tag, followed by the body tag. I'm giving the background color silver. I'm keeping it white only. Let it be white. Right? Now, in order to create the forms in HTML, I'll be making use of table tag, but I'll be taking table without border. I will be taking table without border, right? I don't want to create border. Okay? I don't want to create the border, but I want that structure should be in form of table. Proper alignment should be there of each and every control, each and every label which I'll be taking in the HTML forms. How to start form in HTML? Which tag? Form tag. Personal talking is not allowed. The HTML form starts with form tag, opening and closing. At the end, we close the form tag when our form is created. Okay, a quick revision to all. What are the three attributes of form tag? Action, target, method. What are the two methods which are involved? Get and post. Get and post. Okay. So here, I am starting with the first row. In the first row, I am having first cell where I am typing username. In the first row, in the first cell, I'll be typing the username. Then in the second row, I'll be typing the control. How to create control? With the help of input tag. Input type equal to text. Name equal to T1. Okay, so this closes my first row. Here I close my first row. In the first row, I have two cells. In the first cell, I'm adding the label, that is the username. In the second cell, I'm giving text box. Okay, what is the feature of text box? It is the single line entry box. It is the single line entry box. Okay, what are the attributes of input tag? Type, name, value, ID. Okay, then max length, min length, when we are giving password. What are the attributes of form tag? Name, action, target, method. Name is also an attribute of form tag. Okay. Okay. Is input tag empty or container? Empty. Form tag? Container. Sir, the last PC is not working. Why don't you change your seat? Now, for the next row, I'm copy pasting it. Okay, here I am changing the data. I am giving email and I am giving the text box, but I am giving the name T2. Right? Now in the third text box, I am creating the password. Input type equal to password. Name equal to P1. Name equal to P1. Silence at the back, please. So I have created two controls, text box and password. Okay. Now, after this, see what I'm going to do. I'm going to insert one blank row. All of you check it out. How to insert blank row in the table? How many cells I have in one row? Two. All of you see the LCD. TR, PD, false span equal to 2. Close the TD. Have you seen what I have done? This is my row. Give the stick to me. This is my row. It has two cells, one cell, second cell. Now I want to give the blank row. So I am merging these two cells. And when I am going horizontally across two cells, that means my movement is column wise. So definitely I'll be using the false span. Got it? And don't give any content. Don't give any content. Content means don't fill any data. Right? Now here, I'm going to create the check boxes. TD, hobbies. TD, hobbies. Ek cell mein hobbies. Yahan pe sare check boxes ki list banegi. And it will be having all the hobbies. And you can enable one or two or multiple as per your convenience. See the first command, how to create checkbox. Leave your typing board. For few seconds or minutes, leave your typing work and focus on LCD only. TD. Ab ye wala TD second cell hai. Ye wala. Yahan pe hobbies aa gaya. Second cell. Iska TD open to kar liya. Abhi maine close nahi karna. Jab tak main sare check boxes na laga doon. Input type equal to checkbox, name equal to C1, and I am giving the hobby cricket and apply the BR. Apply the DR. Right? Input type equal to checkbox, name equal to C2, football and BR. I am in the same cell only. In the same cell, every entry will be in the next line. What I want to say, you people. Input type equal to checkbox, name equal to C3, reading and BR. Input type equal to checkbox, name equal to C4, music and BR. So I have given four check boxes in one cell. Now I close the TD. And now I close this row. Got it? I just show the table up till here. I close all the tabs. Right? And I share the browser view with you people. 10th A form revision 10.21.html. Let us see the browser view. Documents, and this is the check it out. See the browser view. These are my check boxes. I can activate all, or I can activate any three, any two as per my convenience. See the alignment and the placement. Properly, text is aligned and properly controls are aligned. Okay, I have a question over here. How many controls I have taken? Two. Two text boxes, one password box, and then check box. So text box, password, and check box. Three controls I have taken. Right? The way you will get the structure of HTML forms, the way you have to manipulate your coding. Please listen here carefully. The way you have the way you have been given the structure in the question paper, the way you have to manage the coding, okay? Right? Now you type this. Now you start typing in your PC, okay? Now after this, I continue here, you type check boxes in your table. I again give the blank row here. Right? And this time I'm going to give the radio buttons. Now here I give the radio button. I am giving the value classes, and here I take the control radio. In radio button, all the controls have the same name. All the entries, they have the same name. Here I'm giving class 9. Again, radio. Name R1. Class I'm giving 10. Name radio. Name I'm giving R1. And here I'm giving plus 1. Again, I'm taking input type equal to radio, name equal to R1, and I'm taking class plus 2, BR, and I am closing the TD, I'm closing the TR. Okay? Let us save the coding and check the browser view. See, the radio buttons have come. Radio button you can enable only one at a time. You cannot select multiple radio button at one time. Okay, got it? See the browser view for radio button. Clear to all? Any doubt, any queries up till here? I'm showing the coding part once again. You all can check it. This is the coding part for the radio button. Clear to all? Any doubt, any queries up till here? No? Yes, backbenchers, any questions? Now, if you want to apply the buttons, I take the TR, PD, call span equal to 2, align equal to center. I am taking the input tag. Submit. Name equal to S1, value equal to submit. PD and TR closes. Right? This is the submit button. Check it out. Now, what I have done in the case of submit button, see the coding. I have combined two cells. Call span laga ke, maine do cells ko combine kiya. Combine karke, I have made the data centrally aligned. Then I have given the command for creating the button. Input type equal to submit button. By clicking on the submit button, your data will get submitted to the server. Okay, and the name I have given S1, you can give any name, and value means the initial value being given to the control, the initial value that you can give to the control. Okay, what is the use of reset button? Helps to set back the form to the default values. Clear? Any doubt, any queries? You can create your reset button also if you want. Name equal to R. Value equal to reset. Quiet. Check it. Two buttons I have created, submit and reset. Like suppose I'm giving the value username Aditya email. Password I'm giving. Hobbies I'm taking. Class I'm taking. These are the values which I have given. When I click on the reset button, the form will again reset back to its default values. Okay? Got it, all of you?